Hello everyone, I hope you and your families are safe. Today we are going to start the last chapter for this year, Internet Research. The first topic will be advantages and disadvantages of Internet Research. Lesson can be found on your book page 219 till 222. Please do not forget to read the book for more detailed information over this topic. If you have any question, please feel free to write me at my email. Also, you may write your concerns on Google Classroom. Reminder: all the assignments should be submitted in Google Classroom. What is Internet Research? Internet research is the practice of using Internet information, especially free information on the World Wide Web, or Internet-based resources in research. Internet research has had a profound impact on the way ideas are formed and knowledge is created. Research includes any activity where a topic is identified and the effort is made to actively gather information for the purpose of further understanding. Internet research can provide quick, immediate, and worldwide access to information, although results may be affected by unrecognized bias, difficult to verify the writer's originality. The first resources retrieved may not be the most suitable resources to answer a particular question. Popularity is often a factor used in structuring internet search results, but popular information is not always most correct or representative of the breadth of knowledge and opinion on a topic. Now, let us discuss about the advantages of internet research. Access to new and valuable sources of information that came into being because of the internet. A more efficient route for accessing certain standard information sources such as newspapers, particularly overseas papers, and electronic version of existing print journals. Access to an enormous amount of information. Currently, it is estimated that there are about 800 million pages of information on the web. Access to obscure and arcane information. Because there are so many people with such diverse interests on the internet, a search can often turn up the most unusual and hard-to-locate nuggets of data. Access to digitized version of primary sources. Some libraries are digitizing, making electronic versions of primary resources such as personal letters, official government documents, photographs, audios, and in some cases also videos. Access to searchable databases and datasets. There are many sites on the internet where you can search a collection of statistical data such as demographic or social science data. With some databases on the internet are fee-based, some other are free. Access to international information. Not only can you easily find official data from other countries by connecting to embassies, consulates, and foreign governmental sites, you can also search other countries' newspapers, discuss issues with citizens from around the world on the news groups, and locate websites established by individuals from other nations. Now, some other key benefits that the internet brings to the researcher may include the speed, for example, so doing a search on the internet can take just seconds, or timeliness. On the internet, you can find information that has just been made available a few minutes earlier, or multimedia. The internet delivers not just text, but graphics, audio, and also video. Hyperlinking, the ability to click between web pages, can facilitate an associative type of research and make it easier to view citations and supporting data from a text. What are the disadvantages of internet research? The first one is the diverse collection of information. The internet is truly a collection of information that's one of its strengths, but it's also one of its weaknesses. On the net, you can come across everything from a scholarly paper published on a particular physics webpage to some other not reliable sources. All of this diversity makes it difficult to separate out and pinpoint just the type of information you want. Difficult to search effectively. A traditional electronic database that you may search in a library may take a little learning and practice, but once you get the hang of it, you can become an effective searcher. But on the internet, even if you know all the ins and outs of searching, because of the built-in limitation of the internet search engines and the way web pages are created, you will only be able to search a small percentage of what's on the net. Emphasizes on new information. So the web came into being in the 1990s, and it has the most information available on the internet post-dates that time. However, this is changing as certain website owners are loading older archival materials. Lack of permanence. Web pages are unstable. They appear, move, and disappear regularly. This can be of particular concern for academic researchers who need to cite a stable page for reference purposes. What is the library research? The research library is a library which contains an in-depth collection of material on one or several subjects. A research library will generally include primary sources as well as secondary sources. Large university libraries are considered research libraries and often contain many specialized branch research libraries. The advantages of library research. Libraries are still the best place to find primarily resources, an essential element in any resource project. And if a library does not have its own copy of a source, it can borrow resources from other libraries through interlibrary loan. Libraries are staffed with librarians who are often subject matter experts or at least knowledgeable about their own collection. Getting a librarian assistant can mean having access to resources you never would have known about. And library collections are heavily vetted. Students can be sure that the majority of items in a library are reliable sources. And the disadvantages of library resources are: time and access can be obstacles to library research. Students must get to the library during library hours, which may not be convenient. They also may need to stay in the library for a long time to ensure they have exhausted all resources. Some resources may not be available for checkout, which means the student must stay in the library to use them. And those that do circulate may be checked out by others and unavailable to anyone else. This is the end of the topic. Please feel free to contact me if you need any further information. You may write me on my email or on Google Classroom. Thank you for your attention.